District Keys Art Mile will soon be the host of the new art and food market called the Pantry Market at Keys in Rosebank. The market is set to take place one Saturday morning a month, and will offer a range of different foods for avid food lovers. And one of the highlights of the market is a stand, a movable feast in which top local chefs will create a product to be sold exclusively at the market. The market is also a plastic-free zone, and visitors will be able to shop for quality, ethically produced products in a more relaxed and curated space. And to tell us more about the market, we're joined in studio by Roberta Thatcher, the curator of the Pantry Market at Keys Art Mile. A very good morning to you, Roberta, and welcome.
Good morning, thank you.
Now, for those that are not familiar with artisanal markets, what will the Pantry Market at Keys in Rosebank offer attendees?
So it'll have all kinds of things that you can stock up your pantry with, hence the name. So everything from cheese to milk to eggs, sourdough bread, honey, chocolates, all that kind of thing. But the beauty of it is that it's all made by local producers, and they will be there selling it themselves. So I think now more than ever, as we've seen with the listeriosis crisis and all that, we really need to know where our food's coming from. It's a responsibility now. So you can go there, chat to someone, ask exactly how the stuff is made, and buy it from them there on the spot.
So who are some of the food makers expected to be participating in this?
So we have a guy from making charcuterie from the Midlands called Esposito Foods, which is the most amazing cold meats and salamis and stuff, which you cannot get in Johannesburg. So I'm really excited about that. And another one I'm really excited about is a honey producer called the Urban Apiary. Oh. And they actually use honey from beehives from the suburbs in Johannesburg. So it really is like properly local. And you can bring your own jar to fill up there. I mean, they'll have ready stock jars as well. But as you mentioned, it's a plastic-free zone. And we're really trying to, you know, impress the message of no waste and, you know, trying to change people's habits. So I love that idea that you can bring your own jar and fill it up with honey.
Wow, interesting stuff. Now, there's so many of these markets around Gauteng, particularly in Joburg. So what sets this one apart from the rest?
Well, firstly, I just think that every suburb should have one. I don't think that you can ever have too many markets, because we need to be able to access local food regularly. And I think this one, it's in the Keys Art Mile, which is a really beautiful art and design district. So it's a lovely setting. And as I mentioned, it's a plastic-free zone. Mm. And it's also just very highly curated. So we're really careful about who we accept into the market. So you know that everything you get there is going to be top, top quality.
What do you mean about plastic-free zone?
So none of the producers can sell their stuff in plastic. So which has actually been, it's been really great, because I think it's three producers so far that I've brought onto the market already did sell their products in plastic.
So you only allow containers in glass?
Glass or paper or biodegradable plastic, or a few of them. But so three of them have actually changed to glass and have said to us that this has really made them think about how they're going to package their products going forward. Right. So I think in a small way, we're making a difference. And the more people that try these initiatives, you know, eventually will change people's consciousness.
I'm curious to know about your stand, the Moveable Feast. What does it entail?
Yeah, it's quite exciting. So, I mean, not all of us have the opportunity to eat at top restaurants all the time. So every month we're going to approach five top chefs, and they are making a product specifically for the market that people can buy there and take home to enjoy at home. And yeah, an example is the restaurant Himmelhase in Cape Town. The chef there has his own citrus garden where he grows all his own oranges, you know, all the kind of citrus fruits. So he's going to be making citrus jams from his own garden that you can then buy and enjoy at home.
Okay. Now, each month visitors can attend, you know, the free food-related talk by industry experts. What can be expected from this, and what sort of topics will be covered?
Sure. So this month, the market's next weekend, so 10:30, Brad is a guy who, he has an organic box scheme, so he sells organic food that's delivered to your house every day. So he's very much involved in this industry, and he's going to be talking about how we've become very disconnected from our food. We don't know where it's made, we don't know who makes it, and his idea is that the dinner table is a place where families can really get reconnected with their food. So he'll be talking at 10:30, and it's a free talk, and anyone can join, and I think it'll, you know, raise some interesting questions.
Great stuff, Roberta. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. Well, that's Roberta Thatcher. He's the curator, or rather, she's the curator for the Pantry Market at Keys Art Mile in Rosebank. This is Morning Live. Let's go for an air break now.